Okay, we're all gathered. Hello, welcome. Thank you for coming to celebrate the achievement of our sixth year students in the Hawthorne Room. They've written some really wonderful speeches and they are the stars of our show, but I would like to just first acknowledge a couple of people, or all of you, that have supporting these students along the way. First of all, thank you, parents. Thank you for all the years that you've stuck with us, brought them to class, carpools, parked around our building, and all the hundreds of volunteer hours that you put in to make this moment possible. So, really, thank you very much from all of you. Secondly, of course, acknowledging our wonderful teaching team that have supported these students. So Stephanie and Kim, who's been with us the last couple of years, Marina, and so many other staff that wrap around these students every day. Thank you all for your support. School, who has a few remarks for you, but Sue Prichter, who captains our ship every day.
I'll be really fast. I have a message for all of these students that's in their binder, but to all of you, I think just continuing with Don's comment, we know that the level of support. Those moments of doubt, sometimes in a Montessori program, this sheer leap of faith. For all of that, we really, really appreciate the time, the effort, and all the support. It's really the little things that I see. An upper elementary student helping a little three-year-old in the dance recital the other night when he decided to just walk off the stage instead of do his dance. Or watching them work with the toddlers in the morning, or reading their service projects and hearing what a service project means to them, or to even see them out on a service project. And then to hear from them how life-changing the experience was for them to take a trip together to Costa Rica. These are the things that keep us going, sustain us, and know that we're sending them off to great adventures with a whole lot of tools in their toolkit. So thank you for your support. Thank you, students. We miss you all. We're glad that we are not going to lose all of you out of sight every day. Thank you.
I'm proud to have had the privilege to work with them and witness them grow into confident, self-assured individuals. We are thankful for Owen's optimism and imagination, he took ideas from lessons and went out of the classroom to consult experts and to find out as much information as possible. And we've enjoyed skits exploring a variety of themes, including lively presidential debates. Cooper's sincerity and calm presence. Always be found working diligently on follow-ups, creating engaging stories such as Douglas Dune, or caring for his beloved, our beloved leopard gecko Chancha. Incredible for her creativity and resilience, she always adds beautiful artistic flourishes to her work in all areas of the classroom. Luchella is a thoughtful community member and always stands up for what is right. Engagement, focus, and wit. He is always quite a Renaissance man and has a wide range of interests. He is widely on his ears and always ready to share that wisdom. His Stella's calm presence and emotional intelligence. She always surprised us with clever presentations and her eagle fur and grounding skit characters. Thanks for showing us how to jam to jazz music in the school band. Alex and his sincerity and optimism. Alex also shared a special love and flair for acting in grounding skits. He gave a rousing portrayal as Sam Adams in the American Revolution play this year. Thank you, Alex. About Luke's Montessori lesson in McCarthyo, despite some challenge that was had, and he'll share that soon. It went well, and he was resilient. You can always count on Luke to volunteer for an activity, or help his fellow students, or other child peace community members. Thank you, Luke. She has a willingness to put in the work academically and socially do her best. Mani's is a grounding presence. Lucia, her optimism, and she has a gracious spirit. We can always count on her for a positive attitude and ideas for solutions. Thank you, Lucia. McCarthyo lesson and the children at the Humanitarian Foundation. And it's very special to see. We've enjoyed his lively debates and his sweet dance moves. Fiona Rose's determination and grit. She is the big sister of the class and a wonderful mentor to our group. She will surely be missed by the toddler community, with whom she shared her kindness and patience. Thank you. Lucas, in his sincerity, diligence, and trustworthiness, you could always be counted on to be a fantastic journal partner and friend. We will miss your kind heart and caring demeanor. And you've always cared for our classroom pets, such as Chancho, who will miss your care. Thank you. And artistry. She can be counted on to add dramatic flair to each and every follow-up assignment. Anna is a kind work partner and friend. We will certainly miss her delicious cupcakes that she shared. And Will's determination, sincerity, and resilience. He could always be found diligently working. Sometimes evidence of his work could be found in several places of the classroom at one time. We are thankful for our time with you, Bo, and we will miss your kind presence. So as you move further down your path, please take what you have learned from your time with us in the Hawthorne Room. And not only apply your many talents, but move forward and strive to build community and care for your new environments. Thank you for all you have taught us, and we are confident you are prepared for your next adventures. Thank you.
All right.
next we get to hear from our sixth year. So we'll just start with Will Cook, and you guys can just rotate up as you finish. Will, you can kick us off.
Hi, everybody. Today I'm going to share with you some of my experience of these 3 years that I've had at Chalkies. So through my time at school, I went to preschool, which I don't remember much from, elementary, and then I came to Chalkies. When I came in fourth grade, I was stunned by how much my environment had changed, because the freedoms, responsibilities, and the ability to explore your own challenges at your own pace was really different. I also learned my strengths and weaknesses and got a lot learned on a wider variety of subjects. When I came to the school, I made friends with Lucas, Cooper, Alex, and Matthew. In fifth grade, I became friends with Levi and Luke. For most of my work time, I worked on state standards, a service project, WPs, writing prompts, math, Spanish, and other researches. My goals at the beginning of sixth grade were to finish state standards and have them in a nice organized portfolio, sharpen my Spanish skills, and to do more challenging work on my own. I finished state standards and did lots of challenging work thanks to my teachers. I also got a lot sharper at Spanish from all the work with Katie. I think sixth grade was by far the hardest year, but also the best and most fun. Every year, the fall upper elementary goes to Eagle Fern for one night. Eagle Fern is a place you go to bond with people, especially people from different classes. It is a very fun experience. I remember in fourth grade, Lucas and I would go down to the river, catch crawfish, and put them in a rock ring and see if they would fight each other. They never did. Also, during the spring, we would have a two-night trip every year. In fourth grade, we went to Camp Self, which is in the Puget Sound off of Vashon Island. We were right along the water, and I vividly remember when Greg went to the shore and caught an octopus with his bare hands. In fifth grade, we went to Camp Hancock, which is up near Fossil, Oregon in the desert. This year we went to OPI Wuji Rainforest. It rained a lot. Costa Rica was probably the best experience of all upper elementary for me. We went for a week and did all sorts of things from ziplining to helping kids in poverty. Every day we would start by eating breakfast. The options were always pancake, rice and beans, a panini, or an omelet. Every day after breakfast, we would go to the CPI Spanish school and have a Spanish class from 10 o'clock to 12 o'clock. We had a great teacher who gave out candy instead of homework to us. We would also have recess at CPI and then do our daily activity. We had a great tour guide. His name was Johnny, and he knew English and Spanish and about everything about Costa Rica. We went ziplining and hiking in the first 2 days. On the third day, we taught little kids in poverty at Macarpio our children's house lessons. The founder and owner of the company, Gail, told us about the many people she had helped. It was truly fascinating listening to her stories. I realized how important it was to give back. At the end, we sang songs with the little kids. We also went on a crocodile boat tour on Thursday and saw all sorts of exotic animals. And after taking a downtown tour of San Jose, we went back to Portland. Service was an important part of my time at Chalkies. In fourth and fifth grade, I was a member of the Green Team. When it came time to choose my service project, I chose the Clark County Food Bank. I think that I had a successful service project because I volunteered 7 times and also ran a successful food drive with Lucas. We raised 400 pounds of food for food insecure people, thanks to all the Chalkies families. Lucas and I also ran the talent show. It was a great experience. Before I leave, I would like to thank the people that made these 3 years of education possible. First, I would like to thank Stephanie, Kim, Marina. I would also like to thank Katie, the upper elementary teachers, and the rest of the Chalkies staff. I would also like to thank Sue for making the school an experience possible. And last but not least, I would like to thank my parents for helping me with this education. Thank you.
Responsibilities are what keep us in check. For every freedom, there's your responsibility. And if you don't fulfill your responsibility, you lose your freedom. This is a great system, I think, because it's very similar to real life and prepares you for adulthood. A Another thing that childhood means to me is personalized education. At most schools, everybody receives the same lesson, but if you're not ready for the lesson, then too bad. At Montessori, you only get lessons that you need, which helps people learn at their own pace. To me, this is the core of Montessori. I first understood how Montessori was different when in first grade, I read a book about a kid who goes to conventional school, and I talked about what he does, and then I realized that Montessori is actually different from other schools. I first came to Child Peace for Children's House. During that time, I mostly played with my friends and slept, but I also learned valuable skills such as cleaning up my work and grace and courtesy. When I moved up to Lower L, I missed some of my old friends who had left Child Peace, but I was excited for a new classroom and a new teacher. I was so happy when I found out I was in the middle room with my best friend Ezra. In Lower L, I learned whole different skill sets, such as math, Spanish, biology, and language. We also got to go to camp every year. I had never been away from my parents for that long, so I was super nervous. When we got there, however, it was awesome, and I remember being the only person in our group to catch a lizard. I was really proud. I was excited for Upper L, but then when I came for my first day, I was terrified. But thankfully, I quickly made friends with other fourth graders, Owen and Alex, and we are still friends to this day. I also learned things I never knew existed, like algebra, different Spanish tenses, and grammar like auxiliary verbs and synonyms, which I previously thought were a type of verb. Another thing I discovered was that not only did we go to camp at the end of the school year, but at the beginning too. It was called Egotherm, and it was fun because we only learned a little bit. We mostly just played games and got to know each other. So now let's fast forward to sixth grade. In sixth grade, two huge things happened. My service project in Costa Rica. In sixth grade, everybody volunteers at an organization. For my service project, I chose the Urban Historical Society, and I'm so glad I did. I volunteered as a docent for their History Hub exhibit four times, and I also went to two meetings regarding the redesign of the new exhibit, Oregon My Oregon. I took surveys from the kids in my class about what they would like the new exhibit to look like, and presented it at a meeting. And in total, I volunteered 12 hours, and I'll continue volunteering through the summer and into next year. The second big thing that happened this year was Costa Rica. The sixth graders all went to Costa Rica for a week and did many things, including teaching at the Costa Rican Humanitarian Foundation's Montessori School in Lucario. While we were there, we got to learn about the poverty cycle and how to break it, and also got to donate used Montessori materials and teach the kids how to use them. It was so fun, and I'm so thankful I got to go, but more importantly, I'm thankful to have been lucky enough to go to Jonathan's Montessori School. I'd like to thank my parents for driving me here each and every day and supporting me, my teachers for teaching me almost everything I know today, and last but not least, my friends for being nice, funny, and helpful times of need.
My name is Finn Schwartz. I've been at Child Peace for roughly 7 years. During my experience, I've learned so much and discovered so many things that I wouldn't have if I were for Child Peace. Freedom. Freedom is a big part of my Child Peace experience. Without freedom, I would not have grown so much and I would not have gotten so far. If it weren't for freedom, I would not be as developed in math. I remember that around the end of fifth grade, I started getting into math. Around that time, I watched a TV show called The Flash. And for those who don't know, The Flash is about a TV show about a man named Barry Allen, who was super smart and, being a detective, he used deductive reasoning and math to solve his cases. I thought that was really cool and useful, and so I was inspired. He was struck by lightning as a particle accelerator exploded, giving him superpowers, and because of the freedom to do any math I wanted whenever I wanted, I could explore math like it was a superpower. This also let me later develop a math partnership called FLOUT, which stands for Finn, Luke, Owen, Will, or Theo. We solved extremely complex algebraic equations together and challenged each other. During my years at Child Peace, I have had many friendships. One of the first ones I remember was with Tam. Back in Children's House, I used to play in the bamboo bushes, and I remember that there was this one kid who seemed really weird that I had never met before. Suddenly, I felt somewhat of a territorial feeling. These bamboo bushes are mine, I thought. That thought quickly went away, because he seemed funny. I don't know what happened next, but I knew we became friends. Sunday, May 14th, 2017. I will never forget that day. Actually, on second thought, I probably will, but I will never forget what happened. May 14th was the day I went to Costa Rica. I was very excited, but I'm also nervous, for I had never been out of the country without my parents. After the painstakingly long flight, we arrived at the Costa Rican airport. I immediately felt a change in community. My most memorable experiences were the Carpio, zip lining, and the waterfall gardens. But I think the one that spoke out to me the most was the Carpio. It felt really good to help out and teach the little kids. I'm very glad that we had the experience because when I came back 10 times more grateful. These are the things that stood out to me the most. If they had not happened, then I would not be here. If it weren't for whatever influenced me starting math, and if it weren't for whatever happened with my friendships in Costa Rica, I would not be who I am. There's many other things that made me who I am during my experience, and Chalkis has given me the option to learn at my own pace, and I miss Chalkis and everything he has done. And now, before I go, I'd like to give some thank yous. My first thank you goes to Marin, who introduced me to Children's House and helped me just start out Chalkis, because I remember I was super nervous that I did not want to go to Chalkis at this day school. Then I'd like to thank Amy for being my teacher in Lower L, and she really helped me learn, and I remember I felt really, really good when I wrote a paragraph, and I think she gave me like a reward or something. I was like super proud about that. And then last but not least, I'd like to thank Stephanie for giving me a great experience in Upper L, and yeah, I'd just like to thank all of Chalkis for giving me everything in my education. Thank you.
I was in the Willow Room. I was very nervous on my first day, but I quickly made new friends, Jackson and Jonathan. I remember during nap time, Jonathan and I wouldn't actually nap, we would just mess around. When I got to school each day, I would sit in the chair next to Veronica, the assistant teacher, until Teresa, the guide, told me to do something else. Then I would play with the binomial cubes until recess. Jonathan and Jackson used to fight over who got to be my partner. Sometimes blood was drawn and the teacher had both of them stay inside. I loved Children's House, but I was ready for Lower L. It was going to be hard because Jonathan was going to be in a different class and Jackson was going to be in a different school. I was going into the Myrtle Room. On my first day to the Myrtle Room, I made a couple new friends. I spent a lot of time with Dylan, Kai, and Elliot. I also liked my teacher, Claire. She was very nice and taught me lots of lessons. One of my favorite lessons was the pin maps. I loved labeling all the countries, rivers, and mountains. This proved to be the groundwork for my love of geography. Some of my assistants were Kevin, Jeff, and Andrea. In second grade, I met a new person named James. We quickly became good friends. In third grade, all my friends went to different schools except for James. We became best friends. He was a year younger than me, so I have to make new friends in Upper L. My first days in Upper L were really fun. I remember thinking, this is so much more fun than Lower L because of the freedom. I knew I was right. Work was much more fun and I was ready for it. I mean, sixth graders go to Costa Rica. I made a lot of friends like Levi, Luke, Will, and Lucas. And it was time for sixth grade. I chose a service project, the Oregon Humane Society. I learned so much about animals. I've had so much fun with this service project. In fact, I volunteered this past Tuesday. Costa Rica, I had so much fun from teaching little kids lessons to exploring San Jose. My favorite part was zip lining through a cloud forest. Flying at high speed through a forest at a couple hundred feet high might seem terrifying, but it's actually pretty fun. This Montessori experience has meant a lot to me. I've made so many friends, done so much work, and helped so many people. I enjoyed my Montessori experience, and I'm glad I will be able to spend 2 more years in Metro. There are some people I'd like to thank. First, I want to thank my teachers for helping me learn all the things I know today. I would like to thank my friends for being supportive and doing lots of work with me. Last, but definitely not least, I would like to thank my parents for making this Montessori experience possible. and for always being positive. I could not have done it without any of these people. Thank you.
All the planning I did, I realized that it's really helpful to be organized. In Costa Rica, one of my favorite parts was teaching my lesson, which were the geometric solids. It was my favorite part because all of the kids were so fun and nice to be around. We were all so excited to learn. There was one kid who was feeling a sphere, and then all of a sudden he was tucked in his shirt and then sprinted through the door. But luckily, when he got back, he was really into the lesson and really helped clean it up. The kid there made me realize how fortunate we really are. They taught me to keep trying, even if we didn't understand. The teacher there, Kale, was amazing. She told us a story about her mom, whose husband went to jail because he was not paying child support, so the mom came to Kale to ask for help, and she helped the woman by paying the child support until the husband got out of jail. She was one of the greatest people I've ever met because she is so helpful and fun to work. Now, as my time here comes to an end, I would like to thank you. First, I'd like to thank my parents for always being there for me. I'd like to thank Stephanie, Kim, and Miranda for always teaching me the things I needed to know and helping me get better at all subjects. And finally, I'd like to thank the school for providing an amazing education. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Lucas and I've been in Child Peace for 7 years. I will share my next 4 minutes with you to talk about my Montessori experience. When I first came to Child Peace, I was in kindergarten. It didn't feel that different to me because I guess my preschool wasn't that much different. The only change I remember was that it was much quieter and more peaceful than my preschool. After the first few days of kindergarten, I was already best friends with William and we would do everything together. William and I were always talking about how we'd become pro football players and we would always play on the playground. After my first year at Child Peace, I was very excited to be in the Red Bird Room and to be in the same class as William. I also became very good friends with Finn Johnson. We did a lot of work together and I was really sad to leave him when I went to Upper L. I really enjoyed Lower L and I'm thankful that I got to go to Montessori at that age. I was very excited to go to the Upper L as I was ready for harder work and I was excited to be in the same class as my older friends again. When I got to Upper L, I was really sad that I wasn't in the same class as William, but I was excited to make new friends. In my first few weeks in Upper L, I was really scared that I had already made friends with Jonah. Fourth grade went by really fast before I knew it was in fifth grade. I really loved fifth grade and it was one of my favorite years of Child Peace. I remember that I especially liked Camp Hancock that year. I made a lot of friends in the large room, and I became better friends with people in the Hawthorne. I really enjoyed that camp, and I was happy to have some time with my friends who were going to Metro. In fifth grade, I also remember doing a research in PowerPoint on Justin Bieber. I was really excited to go into sixth grade, but also really scared. Once sixth grade started, I realized that it wasn't as hard as all the other sixth graders had made it seem. For my service project, I decided to help the Oregon Food Bank. It was a great choice and I really enjoyed it. I got to volunteer there 9 times and hold a food drive with Will. It felt really good to help out so much and I'm really thankful that I got to work there. The rest of sixth grade went by really fast before I knew we were in Costa Rica. While we were in Costa Rica, I became really good friends with William. After we weren't friends for a while. In Costa Rica, my favorite things were the La Paz Waterfall Gardens and La Carpio. I love the waterfall gardens, as well as the amazing wildlife and the great food we ate. And at La Carpio, it was so amazing to teach all the little kids. It was really inspiring to see kids in that much poverty, but still so happy. And it was incredible to see their faces as we showed them our lesson. Sixth grade was really fun, but also challenging. And I'm sad to leave Upper L, but I'm excited to go to Metro, and I'm grateful to have the opportunity to continue Montessori. Over my years at Montessori, I noticed a few themes. One of them was friendship. Over the years, I made so many friends. Montessori really taught me how to be a good friend and understand what my friend needed from me. Another theme was service. I remember volunteering at the Oregon Food Bank when I was in first grade and really loving it and having a great feeling afterwards. After that, I volunteered there a few more times than I did as my service project. Now I have a few people to thank. First, I'd like to thank my parents and grandparents for making this Montessori experience possible, for being supportive of me and my work. All of my teachers for teaching me all the stuff I know and being very helpful and understanding. And lastly, all of my friends for supporting me and helping me through all my work. I'm really thankful for being able to go to a Montessori school, and I'm happy to continue Montessori.
in 7 years. If you don't think yesterday, I was in the middle of a movie clip. Today I'm going to tell you some stories and experiences I've had over the past 7 days. Children's House was really different from the school I came from. The school I came from was a really small Waldorf school with about 5 or 6 other kids. My first day was scary. It was a new environment with a lot more kids than I was used to. One story that I remember very clearly is that Fiona Rose got shiny pink cowboy boots. Then Avery got them, so that meant I felt compelled to get them. My mom took me to the shoe store and we found them, but they didn't fit. I tried to convince her to get them for me anyways, but that didn't work. Children's House taught me a lot. I learned how to make new friends and take responsibility for what I was doing. For example, after I painted, I would have to wash the paper, paste, and palette, and put them back for the next person. In Lowell, I learned how to work more in a group. In first grade, we went to an arms camp called Camp Hancock. I was really excited to go, and it was really fun, just a bit too hot for my liking. I also started to become friends with Avery, the girl who had pink cowgirl boots in Children's House. Avery and I also really enjoyed writing poems together. I graduated third grade reading a receipt from Leonardo da Vinci. I thought Upwell would be a lot like Lowell, but it wasn't anything I expected. I had a lot more work, but also had a lot more freedom and responsibility. In fourth grade, I got to know Maudie and Fiona Roosevelt. I did a lot of my work with Maudie, and we also had a lot of lessons together. The more I got to know her, the more I liked her. When I was introduced to Fiona Rose and started to become friends, I felt complete because I met the girl who started the pink cowgirl group trend in Children's House. I also did a lot of my work with Fiona Rose too. We enjoyed writing researches together, such as our friends and St. Paul's research. On May 14th, all the sixth graders left for Costa Rica. My favorite part of Costa Rica was La Carpia. We weren't there for very long, but it was incredible. I thought it was amazing to teach kids a lesson in Spanish. Also, teaching them the songs we practiced was amazing too. All the hard work from memorizing the songs and lessons was definitely worth it. Lastly, I'm going to talk about some of the services that I've helped and provided over the years, starting out with toddlers. I've always loved hanging out and helping with the toddlers. I especially like to do recess and help. I like recess and helping because I feel like you get the most quality time with them. Next, I will talk about reading buddies. I've had a couple of them. My current reading buddy is Tate. He's so silly and fun, and I definitely see a difference since the first day we started reading together. Finally, my service project. My service project is the Sunshine Division. I found this project because of the name. When I saw the name, the Sunshine Division, I became interested. The Sunshine Division helps homeless and low-income people get food and clothes. When I volunteered there, I would sort clothes. I definitely feel like I made a difference because whenever I went there, I worked for 3 or 4 hours straight sorting and hanging clothes. Thank you for listening to my speech. I would like to thank all of my teachers. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't know what I know now. I would like to thank all of my friends for being with me and supporting me through the years. And lastly, my parents for making my education possible. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed.
Hello there, my name is Fiona Rose Thomas. I've been at Child Peace for 11 years, and it has been a great experience. This school has given me many opportunities to learn, and I have made many friends here. All those friends have made my journey through Child Peace so much easier and a lot more fun. I hope that they will continue to do that and help me along my way. When I first came to this school, I was 15 months old and my class was the Laurel Room. I was a late talker and so was one of my classmates. Almost every day, I would come home with a note that would say I bit a child or sat on them, and as a result, I got bit. That child was always Lucia. As soon as she learned the word no, it all stopped. No more notes, no more violence. Next came Children's House. I moved to the Maple Room when I was 3 years old. I have a lot of memories and stories that I remember from when I was younger. I think the one that I remember most clearly is every day I would come into the class and I would find William. And then we would go to a mirror and stand back to back to see who's taller. We are almost always equal, but if we measure now, then I would win. Towards the end of Children's House, I realized that work wasn't always that fun. So I started to lay down on the quiet mat and lay there fake sleeping until the end of the morning. Then after about 2 weeks of me fake sleeping, my teacher Stephanie forbade me from sleeping because I was going into first grade soon. I graduated kindergarten when I was 6 years old, taking my experiences and my Tiger's Eye graduation stone with me into my upcoming years in Redwood. My my years of child peace happened recently. Wait, no. My first days in the rec room were terrifying and thrilling at the same time. I loved my teachers who were Sora and Millie, and I made fast friends with Bridget and Kira. One memory from Lower L is making my sweet cardboard gray whale Billy, which is 16 feet long. He was one of my most proud achievements, and then one afternoon when I was in aftercare with my friend Kira, we were in our class talking to our teacher when we heard a weird rippy thing. We looked up and Billy, my poor whale, was hanging in two halves. So we radioed Dan and we fixed Billy about mid-day. I had so many sweet memories, fantastic friends, and kind teachers that I wasn't sad leaving the rugby room behind. Because I knew that the next people coming into the class would be able to share and create their own memories. My highlight of all my years of child peace happened recently, and that highlight was Costa Rica. I loved being able to bond with my classmates, and it was an eye-opening experience. I really enjoyed all the activities in CPI, but none of those compared to how much I enjoyed La Carpia. When we went there, I really loved seeing the kids' happy faces when we showed them the materials and sang songs with them. I loved being able to give back to their community. In Costa Rica, I learned a lot, not only about the Costa Rican community and what it's like to be out of the country, but I also learned more about myself and who I am. During my time at Child Peace, I have done several different services for our school and community. Some of those services are helping out with the toddlers and helping younger kids in Lower L and Children's House learn to read. I have had two service projects in the sixth grade. Those projects are Holiday Park Plaza and 13th Salmon, which is a homeless shelter. Currently, my project is still 13th Salmon, and I love going and hanging out with families. I hope you enjoyed learning about my time here at Child Peace. Before I finish my speech, I'd like to thank my parents for supporting me throughout my journey for enrolling me in the school. I'd like to thank my little brother, Gordon, for always being so happy all the time. I would like to thank my teachers throughout the years for helping me learn everything I have and for also being supportive. And lastly, I would like to thank my friends for being so thoughtful and helping me through this journey in and out of school. Thank you all so much. I hope to see you next year in Metro.
I've been in Child Peace for 4 years. Montessori has been very helpful to me because you can learn at your own pace. I've accomplished a lot of my goals and while doing that made even more friends. When I came to Child Peace in third grade, I was put in the gym for room and level. Ella showed me around and she became one of my first friends, along with Anna and Naya, Olivia, Marla, and Piper. My teachers were Amy and Tommy. One of my favorite works in the lower was fractions and math background. They were challenging but fun. I also loved my first camp that I went to. It was Camp Hamlet. I became friends with Margaret. One story I have about third grade is that Piper, Olivia, and I had a club called Mom. It was a book club and we had a lot of fun reading together. In Upper Out, I made some new friends, like Stella and Bridget. I met Stella on the playground and we just started waving at each other like crazy and Stella went over and talked for a really long time. Anna was also still my friend because she moved into Hawthorne. I also became friends with some people a year or two above me. Bella, Paloma, and Elgin. Bella and I had lots of funny experiences cleaning the geometry shelf together. For example, she'd take a sphere and pretend to lay an egg. My teachers in Upper Elementary have been Stephanie, Kristen, Evan, Shannon, and Maria. I also did a lot of service during my years in the hospital, such as toddlers, where I got to help toddlers make banana bread, or sometimes even play with at recess. I also was a reading buddy for 3 years. I loved watching them progress and seeing their happy faces when it was reading. My service project, I volunteered in the children's book series. It felt really nice to know how many books are going into the hands of children in low-income neighborhoods. I went 5 times, meeting new people each time. In sixth grade during May, we all left for one of the most amazing experiences in my life. We went to Costa Rica. I had a chance not only to improve my Spanish, but also to bond more with our kids. Over the course of the trip, I became better friends with Avery and Emery, and I'm looking forward to moving on to Metro. We went ziplining, swimming, and went to a soccer game. So my highlights were La Paz Waterfall Garden, where I almost got run over by an ox with Avery, but most of all, La Carpia. I loved teaching the little kids and seeing them happy to learn. My lesson was the geometric cabinet in Ellen and Allen's. My Montessori experience has meant a lot to me, but it would not have been half as amazing without all my friends. I'd like to thank all of my teachers for helping me on my journey, and my parents and sister for always supporting me.
Thank you.
called a community. Throughout my experience, I've learned so much, and if it weren't for Child Peace, I would never have gotten to experience all the freedoms and amazing ways of learning that we have gotten to know throughout the years. Children's House has taught me a lot about Montessori and what it means to be part of that community. When I was in Children's House, I was in the Pine Room. My teachers were Kathy, Anastasia, and Mary. Some of my favorite works back then were the metal insets, the small bead frame, and I always loved drawing out. I had so many great friends back then, and some of them I'm still great friends with these days. Uphill's been my favorite 3 years because you get a lot more freedoms and you get to work with Lower L and Children's House kids, and that is always a lot of fun. My teachers in Upper L were Stephanie, Kristen, Evan, Kim, and Marina. In the Upper L, all the sisters do a service project. My service project was CHAP. CHAP stands for Children's Healing Art Project. I volunteered 5 times and I went 1 other time. That time I did an in-service. I love my service project and it was so fantastic because you got to do whatever you want as long as you got the project done. At my in-service, I did one of my favorite projects. I took a big group of people and they were Aiden, Sabine, Claire, Ryan Kay, Ursula, Tilly, and Avery. What we did is we took envelopes and painted and drew on them. Everyone had a lot of fun and we were all covered in paint by the end. Everyone was super creative in how they decorated their envelopes. One thing that I really like about Upper L is that you get to go to 2 camps a year instead of just one. The first one is at the beginning of the year, and that is Eagleford. Eagleford is a great camp because you get to know all the new kids that are in your class and the other classes for class. As a sister, you get to help lead cabin. At the end of the year, we always go to a 3-day overnight camp. This camp is always more educational, I would say, and you get to learn cool facts about the wildlife and plants wherever you go, from the desert to the Olympic Peninsula. In Lower L, you go to 1 camp a year, but you still have a lot of fun. In sixth grade, all the sisters go to Costa Rica for a graduation camp. Costa Rica is one of the best parts of Upper L. One thing we did was we gave Montessori lessons to the kids at Costa Rica at La Parfia. It was my favorite part of Costa Rica, and I will never forget how happy some of the little girls were. It was so enjoyable to see that they made them laugh, and they seemed to love having us there. We also sang and talked, so we would sing one song, and then we sang it again, and they sang with us. In Costa Rica, I became a lot better friends with the people in March, and I look forward to spending more time with them in Metro. The experience of traveling outside the country without my family and with my school was very exciting. I love Child Peace, and it has been one of the best experiences of my life so far. My teachers have been so great, and I am going to miss them. My teachers have taught me so much, and I wouldn't be here for them. I'm going to miss my friends, and I'm going to miss schools, and I hope I meet great new people. And I definitely would not have been in this spot if it weren't for my parents. I love them so much, and my brother's so great. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Anna. I am 12 years old and I have been going to Child Peace for 9 years now. Today I'm going to share with you some of my experiences and my favorite things about being a part of this community. I came to Child Peace 9 years ago when I was 3 years old. I was in the Terrace. My best friends in school were Lily, May, Tessa, Maddie, Ira, and Asa. I remember that I could spend all day just washing placemats. I guess I really loved to do it since I remembered it. I'm not exactly sure why I liked it, but maybe it was just satisfying to see something get cleaned. Soon I went into Lower Elementary. I was in the Juniper Room with Amy and Ashley. My host was Ellen, which was good because we were friends. First grade was easy and a nice welcome. In second grade, I had a lot of trouble with the math flashcards, though in third grade, things changed. My two best friends, Chiara and Matea, were gone in Italy for a year, so I had to make some new friends. Bonnie came to visit in second grade and joined the classroom in third grade, and they became friends very quickly. I also became really good friends with Naya that year. That year, we went to Camp Hancock. I was in the cabin with Sabine, MJ, and Naya's mom. One morning at Hancock, we were having pancakes for breakfast. I went up to the counter to ask the cook for more pancakes for our table. The cook said, "I'm so sorry, but we're out of pancakes. Blame everything on me. My name is Bob." So from then on, everything bad that has happened, I blamed it on Bob. Soon, Upper Elementary came. I was really happy when I heard that I was in the Hawthorne Room with Maudie and Kiara. I thought that fourth grade would be like first grade all over again. Well, actually, I was wrong. I had a lot of trouble with math that year again, so I had to have a lot of help, especially with the multiplication and division activity sets. My teachers in Upper Elementary have been Stephanie, Kristen, Mr. Edgner, Kim, and Marina. Kristen was the one who helped me the most with getting organized. She would just sit with me and go over my green sheet. Then came fifth grade. After a little while, I caught up in math, but then I had to do fractions which I didn't understand. Later in the year, I had more help and I understand them very well now. My friends were Jamie, Maudie, Bridget, James, Adelaide, and Alina. I remember that Alina and I tried to do the talent show that year. We wanted to sing and dance to the song, What Is This Feeling from Wicked, which was our favorite musical. In the end, we didn't do it after all our background dancers quit. Then the end of the year came, and I was a little bit nervous for sixth grade. At the beginning of the year, I felt that it would be a lot more stressful than it has been. And we also went to Costa Rica. We left on May 14th. I was in a room with Stella and Piper, which was really fun, and I got to be better friends with both of them. Ziplining in La Paz and La Carpia were my highlights. La Paz was the waterfall garden that we went to on the second day. One of my favorite parts was when Molly almost got run over by an ox. La Carpia was a really moving experience because I knew that I was making a difference in those kids' lives by teaching them how to do things like math and how to use some of the five senses. I also did a lot of service in FRL, including toddlers reading buddies La Carpia and my service project. I was a liaison for the Spruce Room reading buddies with Leo. I liked to see their joy on their faces when it was time to read. My service project was the terrace. I went five times and my mentor was Carol Johnson. It was really fun working with the children and residents, and if I wasn't moving and it wasn't a school, I would definitely continue to volunteer. Thank you for listening to my speech. I would like to thank all of my teachers, my parents, and my friends for supporting me over the past 9 years. Thank you. I have grown tremendously over the past year, and I think my parents and teachers know this. I have become a better person because of Montessori, and my academic skills have improved exponentially because of Montessori. This school program has helped me grow as a person and as a student. Nobody knows if Montessori or Petco fueled my mouse obsession, but that is a mystery that might never be understood. Revelations aside, let's get on to my speech. In first, second, and third grade, Spanish was a whole new world or language for me. I remember when, in lower L, I painted a giant pink rabbit and spelled Conejo at the bottom. This project was one of the stepping stones in my Espanol experience. Over time, my words in Spanish have evolved into complex sentences, and pretty soon I wrote a full-fledged telenovela. This is all thanks to Conti, my wonderful Spanish teacher who pushed me to be my best. Costa Rica was absolutely breathtaking. Colorful birds and sexy animals were absolutely everywhere, and soon I became the bug protector of the trip. I saved insects from various places, such as restrooms, walls, and pools. And this became obvious when I was at a restaurant and people went down the stairs to wash their hands. Screams ensued from that stairwell and everyone ran back up. I asked someone what happened and they said a very large beetle was hogging the stairs. I ran back down the stairs and found the beetle who was indeed hogging the stairs. I picked it up, put it on a paper towel, and ran it outside. I showed it to Johnny and he said it was an ox slash elephant beetle. I urge you to look it up after the speeches. And you'll see it on that website that these beetles can be 2 inches long. Giant insects aside, let's move on to a more somber topic. La Carpia is a small town that is affected by poverty. You can see stray dogs everywhere and trash is littered on the ground. In this town, there is a place with a little more hope, the Costa Rican Humanitarian Foundation. Here, kids ages 1 to 10 play and learn, and on the shelves, there are worn-out Montessori materials, well-loved, and among them to the children, using them and learning from them. Our mission was to bring new materials and to teach them to the kids. I taught the rough and smooth boards with Kieran and Lucia, and the kids really loved it. After that, we sang Spanish songs to the kids while they ate pastries and had hot cocoa. It was truly an eye-opening experience, and I really enjoyed it. Speaking of service, my service project was Pink Phoenix. Pink Phoenix is a team of dragon boat racers made up of breast cancer survivors. I went and volunteered at an issues conference, and I talked to people about my mom's experience paddling with them. I brought my mom's wooden paddle and set it with the rest of the paddles on display. I really enjoyed my time there, and I hope to volunteer against it. Let's talk about art. Art is my favorite subject by far, and I incorporate art into every nook and cranny of every single subject I can, turning boring social sciences into fun and interesting comics, or making a portrait from a literature book. I continue to write, draw, sketch, and paint just about every day when I'm not overly watching mouse training videos. And my scribbles have evolved into masterpieces, and I'm really proud of that. Before I wrap this up, I have a few people to thank.
My teachers, who have taught me everything I know, for supporting me on my journey, and my parents for supporting and loving me every step of my life. Thank you.
Very good. Kimbalota up to help us give the gifts. Kim has supported these students for the last couple of years and is moving on to guide a classroom of her own, but we're really going to miss her.
Go visit with Sue and your teachers. We have a couple gifts for you, and then I'm going to have you all line up at the front of the stage and have a moment. You can leave your speeches just on your chairs for right now. Alright, so Owen Graham.
Stella Nye.